he drive, but don't tell him I said that. You in? I'll let Alex know. He's been waiting to hear if you wanted the business.
Hey, great to see you. Look, I've got a bit of a business idea here. There's loads of cars around here that have real potential. I call them upgrade heroes. You go get the car, we do the magic, then show everyone what an upgrade hero can do. Sounds good? Good. Uh-oh, and you get to drive the courtesy car. You ready for this? We're going to teach the whole of Horizon that with a wee bit of an upgrade, any car can be a hero. Let's get to work.
In 400 meters, turn left. Turn left. In 200 meters, turn right. Turn right. In 200 meters, turn right. Turn right.
Right, here's where we're supposed to make our very first pickup. Are you nervous? Me? I'm not nervous. The 510, not bad. Japanese engineering, European styling. Best of both worlds, really. Got a good one to start, a Datsun. A client says it was the first car they ever owned and they always dreamed of winning races in it. Or at least, you know, being able to overtake something. Bring it back, but try not to smash it up. Remember, it's not yours.
In 200 meters, turn left. Turn left. Turn left. Turn left. In 200 meters, turn right. Turn right.
Excellent. I'll get the team to work. It's ready. You ready? Oh, I'm ready. Ta-da! What do you think? We've gone lower, wider, faster. Twin turbo inline six under the hood producing 337 horsepower. Oh, and there's that nonsense we strapped to the front too.
Time to show it off. How about you take it into Edinburgh? And feel free to, you know, open it up on the way. Listen to that. Never heard a Datsun sound like that, have you?
Take the first exit.
Under specific instructions to be as loud and fast and conspicuous as possible as we go through the city. I think our client might have friends here. Fantastic, did you have fun? Well, if it got your blood pumping, then I'm sure the client will be over the moon. I have a feeling we won't need to wait too long for another one.
Hello again. Remember when I said we'd have clients lining up in no time? Well, we've got clients lining up. So it's go time. The client is an old Audi to just putter around town in, but they've always wanted to go off-road. This is one after my own heart. Let's help them out.
Turn around when it is safe to do so. You will arrive at your destination.
Right, wait there. It'll be along in a minute. It's a Sport Quattro. An 83, I think. See, they stripped all the fun stuff out and sold a few of them as production cars, which is where this one must have come from. So it turns out the client doesn't just want to go off-road. They want to go off-road, Group B style. Well, off we go. Don't crash it on the way back. Cheers. The team can't wait. This thing was built for Group B rallying, which, as we know, was completely mad. But hey, we like mad.
All done. You want to see it? Now, it's got the trademark four-wheel drive system, which should help you handle the dirt. And we've bumped it up to 800 brake horsepower, which might not help, but oh, blimey, it'll be good fun.
I've laid in a rally route for you. I tried to convince a client to sit in his co-driver, but They were a bit too scared. In a rally route for you. I tried to convince a client to sit in his co-driver, but they were a bit too scared. Load of hell-destroying power you've got there. Those springs and dampers handle the downhill. Group B lives. Couldn't be happier. Oh, one more thing. I'm putting all of these in the auto show with the specs and modifications listed for all to see. Be your own upgrade hero. Got a ring to it, don't you think?
Guess what? Our upgrade hero home kits have been flying off the shelves at the auto show. I figured you should get a royalty. After all, it's your driving that sells them. Nick's client says they're already packing some serious American muscle, but they want to see if we can beef it up at all. Off you go.
Turn right.
There for the pickup. Good. Let's see what we've got. Whoa. El Camino Supersport 454. 454 cubic inches of engine. What on earth did it want us to do with... all right then. Challenge accepted, my friend. Try not to damage it, and try not to flog it too hard. Yet.
Turn left. Turn left.
Thank you kindly. I'll get the team to work.
I think you're gonna like this one, but best prepare yourself. We chucked in a 7-litre supercharged V8. Makes over 1,000 horsepower. I'm scared to even stand near it.
They dared us to beef this thing up. Well, let me show this client we're not afraid of a little dare, eh?
Tell the client they can have their beefed up muscle car back, if they're not too chicken.
You may have met this next client, actually. Rob Glenn. Runs Drift Club here at the festival. Anyway, says he's got a Mazda we can look at. And I think I know what he wants done with it.
Turn left. In 200 meters, turn right. Turn right. In 200 meters, turn sharp left. Turn sharp left. Me. metres. Turn left. Turn left. In 200 metres, turn left. Turn left.
Rob can't make it, so he's having one of his drift clubbers bring the car down. Bingo, RX-7. Totally reliable and maybe the best drift platform ever built. Get it down here. If it's a Mazda I think it is and he wants what I think he wants, this shouldn't be too hard. And we haven't even started fiddling yet, so try to keep the back end on the road, eh?
In 200 metres, turn right. Turn right. Meters, turn sharp right. Turn sharp right. In 200 meters, turn left. Turn left. In 200 meters, turn right. Turn right.
For that, I'll get the team started.
Right, are you ready to see Rob Glenn's new toy? It's a wide-body drift conversion. Seriously, you and Rob are going to be the envy of everyone at Horizon Drift Club.
Let's take it down to Edinburgh, shall we? I've heard they have street corners there.
Turn left. Roundabout, take the first exit. In 400 meters, turn right. Turn right. In 200 metres, turn right. Turn right. In 200 metres, turn left. Turn left. At the roundabout, take the second exit. In 400 metres, turn sharp left. Turn sharp left.
Ah, lovely view from the castle, isn't it? Enjoy. It's about to get a lot quicker and more sideways. I've set you a route around the city. Should get those drift clubbers talking. Now, the trick is not to stomp the throttle too hard. You have to feather it into the turn. Just my opinion. Ask Rob if you want the full lecture. Right, time to let that back end go.
In 200 metres, turn left. Turn left. Turn left. In 200 metres, turn right. Turn right. In 400 metres, turn left. Turn left.
Hi, that's it, keep going. We've still got a finish line to get to, remember.
Calculating route. Turn around when it is safe to do so.
Traction, eh?
Well, it is a fun car. Look, I tell you what, we won't tell the client about that bit.
Right, time to let that back end go.
In 200 metres, turn left. Turn left. Turn left. In 200 metres, turn right. Turn right.
Aye, that's it, keep going. We've still got a finish line to get to, remember.
In 400 metres, turn left. Turn left. Turn around when it is safe to do so. Recalculating route.
Look at you go! Who needs traction, eh?
We'll be right back.
down. Takes some people a long time to master this, you know. Stop making it look so easy.
Wow, that was unexpected. It won't do though. Right, come on, try again.
Right, time to let that back end go.
In 200 metres, turn left. Turn left. Turn left. In 200 metres, turn right. Turn right. In 400 metres, turn left.
Aye, that's it, keep going. We've still got a finish line to get to, remember.
Turn left.
Look at you go! Who needs traction, eh? Down. Takes some people a long time to master this, you know. Stop making it look so easy. Well, next time Rob Glenn corners me for a good long chat about the finer points of drifting, I'm telling him to call you.